belongs to him. All praise belongs to him. So I pray this morning on Resurrection Sunday, you find a newness and an appreciation for what our God did, for what he has done for you and for me. I pray this morning that you find a new appreciation for him. It's not another ritual. It's not a feel-good moment. It's a time to reflect on his goodness for you and for me. So I pray this morning that it's not a ritual, because today is one of the most packed days on a Sunday morning, where we just go because it's Resurrection Sunday. But I want this year to be a transformation in your life. And throughout March, I preached on Easter, resurrection, the crucifixion, Holy Saturday, the whole nine yards. Because I want to emphasize the importance of who he is. And this morning, the topic is the undefeated one is coming back again. We all know that he's risen, yes. And across probably the entire world today, that's the headline for every sermon, he has risen. But this morning, I want to implore you that if the undefeated one is coming back again, the undefeated one is coming back again. So I pray this morning that you put your seatbelt on and you glorify the Most I Am that I am. You lift up the name of the Most High God this morning, because he's the undefeated one and he's coming back again. Hallelujah. Father, I just want to thank you this morning for the download. I thank you this morning that you keep on pouring in and pouring out. I thank you this morning, Lord God, that you never fail. I thank you this morning that you are not still. I thank you this morning that you do not sleep and you do not slumber. I thank you this morning, God, that you are alive and well. I thank you this morning, Lord God, that you are speaking and your words reverberate across the entire human race this morning. No grave can hold your body down because you are alive and well. Hallelujah. And this morning, you're making your presence known. So Father God, as I decrease and you increase, have your way this morning and speak, because your children heareth thee this morning. I thank you, Almighty God. Have your way in this place. Amen and amen. So again, this morning, the title is The Undefeated One is Coming Back Again. And this morning, the scripture is taken from John 16, verse 33, and it reads as thus. Jesus said to his disciples, "These things I have spoken unto you, that in me he may have peace. In the world he shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world." So for 3 days, all the demons of hell rejoiced, and Satan and the foes of darkness thought they had won a great victory. For 3 days, the Jewish leaders, as well as the Roman government, congratulated themselves on their brilliant scheme. But on the third day, somebody say third day, something wonderful and miraculous happened. As God the Father said to an angel in heaven, "Go get him." And when the angel's feet hit the ground, the the stone rolled away, and up from the grave Jesus arose by his own power. And after 3 days, they saw an empty tomb. Not only did they see an empty tomb, but they saw a folded napkin in that empty tomb. I want you to know that he's not finished yet. He's coming back again. In John 19, verse 30, Jesus said, just before he died, it is finished. That is what he came to do on his first visit, but his work only began. I submit to you today that he's not finished saving souls. The Bible says that Jesus came into the world for one reason, to save sinners. John 3 verse 17, for God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Acts 4 verse 12, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under earth given among men whereby we must be saved. He's not finished yet. The undefeated one is coming back again. So today I want to tell you about the undefeated one who overcame death, hell, and the grave. My God, my God, the undefeated one who overcame death, hell, and the grave. My God, my God. So when Jesus uttered the words, in the world he shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. I want you to know this morning that he had not yet endured the agonies of the Garden of Gethsemane, the cruel mockery, the brutal beatings, the spitting, and the torture inflicted both by the Jews and the Romans. His loyal followers had not yet abandoned him. His disciples had not yet betrayed him. And one of his closest friends had not yet denied him the cross where he would hang, forsaken by his father, for the only time in all eternity laid ahead. Yet even in that moment, the tense he used, I have, rather than I will, revealed that he had already triumphed over the world. His sacrificial role as the lamb slain since the foundation of the world, as foretold in Revelation 13, verse 8, was unwavering. As its followers, we too can face any trial, because in him we share in that victory. This morning, we share in his victory. So take courage, embrace your purpose, and walk in the joy and glory God has prepared for you and me. Jesus, you see, the ultimate conqueror, came to overcome. He conquered, and his words reverberated with power. After uttering these truths, Jesus journeyed to the cross, where he disarmed the rulers and authorities of this world, and their weapons were rendered useless. Yes, their powers, their weapons were rendered useless. And the sting of sin and death were removed by the Lamb of God. In 1 Corinthians 15, Jesus is victorious. He emerged from the grave triumphant, exalted at the right hand of the Father. He sent his spirit to come and dwell inside of you and me, a promise echoed throughout John chapters 14, 15, and 16. I don't want you to miss this morning. The resurrected King of Kings and the Lord of Lords resides in you, and his Spirit is your constant companion. Why? His Spirit dwells and resides in you and me. So lift your head high this morning. Regardless of the storms raging around you, remember this. You are an overcomer. My God, this morning, I want you to remember this. You are an overcomer. Jesus' undefeated power dwells and runs through your veins this morning. So let your praise rise to Yahweh, the I am that I am this morning. Do not doubt for a moment that you are defeated. Even though your circumstances and what your eyes are telling you this morning, you are undefeated as well. Within you resides the overcoming, conquering King of all creation. He walks beside you because you are his own. Lift up your head high, for he is your helper. He is your Ebenezer stone. He is your strength. He is your joy, and he is your peace. So look up and fix your gaze upon him, the source of your hope and your victory this morning. Take heart, because Jesus, who conquered sin and death, stands with you. Praise him for disarming work according that was accomplished on the cross. For his resurrection, it was his victory and his triumph over the grave. His ascension to the right hand of the Father proves that he's alive and well. As John 1, as 1 John 5, verse 4 declares, for everyone born of God overcomes the world. This is the victory that has overcome the world. For everyone born of God overcomes the world. This is the victory that has overcome the world. He is the one that overcome. He overcame the world. He overcame death. He conquered death. So as a result this morning, the culmination is he is the undefeated one. And the Bible declares him as the King of righteousness, the King of the ages, the King of heaven, the King of glory, the King of kings, the Lord of lords. Do you know him this morning? Do you know the one in whom I speak of? My God, this morning, do you know him? As David proclaimed in Psalms 19, verse 1, the heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament shows his handiwork. I subscribe to you this morning. Do you know him? My king is a sovereign king. I want to tell you a little bit about him this morning. His love defies measure. No telescope can reveal the boundaries of his boundless provision. No obstacle impedes his blessings. He is unwaveringly strong, genuinely sincere, eternally steadfast, gracefully immortal, and imperially powerful. His mercy knows no partiality. Have you encountered him this morning? If you haven't, draw a little bit closer to me this morning, and let me tell you about my king. He is the greatest phenomenon to grace our world. God's son, a savior for sinners, the cornerstone of civilization. My God, he is a chief cornerstone. He stands in solitude of himself. He is awesome, unique, unparalleled. unparalleled and unprecedented in literature. He represents the loftiest idea in philosophy. He's the highest personality. He's the supreme problem in higher criticism. He's the foundational doctrine of true theology. He's the cardinal necessity of spiritual religion. All converge in him. I said, do you know him this morning? Do you know him? Because he's the miracle of the age. He embodies everything good. He alone qualifies as the all-sufficient savior. Do you know him? Today, he strengthens the weak. He stands by the tempted. He sympathizes with the tried. And he saves this morning. He strengthens and sustains. He guides, my God, and he, oh my God, and he guides you and shepherds you. He heals the sick. He cleanses the leper. He forgives sinners. He destroys and discharges debt. My God, he delivers the captives. He defends the feeble. He blesses the young. He serves the unfortunate and the marginal this morning. He regards the aged. He rewards the diligent and he beautifies the meek. I wonder if you know him. Do you know him? Well, my king is the king. He's the key to knowledge. He's the wellspring to wisdom. He's the doorway of deliverance. He's the pathway of peace. He's the roadway of righteousness. He's the highway of holiness. He's the gateway of glory. So you know him. Well, his office is manifold, cannot be numbered or quantified. His purpose and its promise is sure. His light is matchless. His goodness is limitless. His mercy is everlasting. His love never changes. His word is enough. His grace is sufficient. His reign is righteous. His yoke is easy and his burden is light. I wish I could describe him to you, but he is indescribable. All I'm doing is just scratching the very surface, oh my God, of who he is, because he's incomprehensible. He's invisible. He's irresistible. Well, you can't get him out of your mind. You can't outlive him. You can't live without him. The Pharisees couldn't stand him, but they found out they couldn't stop him. Pilate couldn't find any fault in him. The witnesses couldn't get their testimonies to agree. Herod couldn't kill him. Death couldn't handle him. And the grave couldn't hold him. My God, yes. That's my undefeated king. That's my king. Father, yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. How long is that? Somebody will ask. And when you get through with all the forever, then amen and amen. That's my king. Do you know him this morning? Yes, that's my king. What did I just say? That's my king. And that's your king. And I sure hope you know him. Or draw a little bit closer to him this morning. Isn't it about time you give him the time and the honor worthy of a king? You have someone who cares about you more than you can fathom or even comprehend. He is the king. This king guides you to holiness with his scepter. This king rules as one with the Father and the Holy Spirit. This king watches over you and protects you from all harm and danger. My God, this king isn't afraid to take action and serve Who wouldn't want to know this king? This king is willing to die for you, and he did. He did so on the cross to make sure your sins are forgiven. This king gives you peace and eternal life. This is your king. My God, with him, you are undefeated. He has never lost a battle, no matter how hopeless the situation looked. And yes, you're all facing dire situations. But Yahweh, our God, the I am that I am, has never lost the battle. God is winning the battle. And in the end, we're going to come out on the winning side, because the battle is already fixed. It's already won. And between now and then, be encouraged and don't be deceived by the appearance of things around you. The story of Jericho tells that when the people obeyed, God showed up and the walls fell down. How many people need a showing up today? How many people need God to show up in your circumstance? What did I just say? Jericho, when the people obeyed, God showed up and the walls came down. My God, this morning I subscribe to you. All you got to do is obey, and God shows up, and the walls come down. When Lazarus was in the tomb, it may have been seen that Jesus would arrive late, but he had greater plans than healing. Jesus called out to Lazarus, and his life returned. Yes, 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 yes. My God, how many, oh my God, this morning that needs a Lazarus to come forward. My God, Lazarus was in the tomb, like I said, and it seemed like Jesus had arrived late, but he had greater plans that God is having for you this morning. He has a greater plan for you, greater plans than just healing, because Jesus called out to Lazarus and his life returned. Some of you need life to be returned unto you. Some of you need restoration. Can these dry bones live again? Oh, yes, they can. Oh, the word was given. The command was given. And dry bones came alive again. Oh, my God, there weren't any misfits. Every bone that needed to be in its right place came back into place and came back into position. Can the dry bones live again? Yes, they can. Also for you this morning that are thrown in the towel and said, no, I'm too old. No, I'm too washed up. No, it's too late. What did I just say? My God, Lazarus was in the tomb. My God, and they thought that Jesus would arrive too late, but he had greater plans. Jesus called out to Lazarus, and it's life returning. In 2 Chronicles 20, verse 15, the Spirit of the Lord speaks to all of Israel. My God, and it says, listen, all Judah and inhabitants of Jerusalem and King Jehoshaphat, thus said the Lord to you, do not be afraid and do not be dismayed at this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's. Yes, this morning, my God, I'm speaking to you. The battle is not yours, but it's God. So do not be afraid and do not be dismayed at this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's. So when God calls us to action, the power of success is in his hands, not yours. I want to repeat that for somebody this morning. When God calls you to action, the power of success is in his hands, not yours. So let that encourage you today. Because a battle is not yours, but it's the Lord. And our God has not lost a battle, because he is undefeated. And he gives us the strength We need to fight each day's battle. Somebody needed to hear that. Our God has not lost a battle. He's undefeated. And he gives us the strength we need to fight each day's. He has indeed overcome the world system, the power of the flesh, and the wiles of the devil. He paid the price of sin, of all the sins committed, and he broke the power of sin. That old sin nature, he broke it. He broke it. He broke the power of death and hell. And in so doing, he poured out the most astonishing cascade of the riches of God's amazing grace on all who would believe in his name. Do you believe in his name this morning? Take heart. I have overcome the world. It's a simple statement from a gracious Savior. But the grace and glory that flows from his words of depth and deep comfort will resound throughout eternal ages to come. So however dark your own life situation may be, and whatever challenges you may be facing, take these words to heart. I have overcome the world. I have overcome the world. Because he's alive in me. He's not in the grave. The tomb is empty. And he lives forevermore. He lives forevermore. And because he lives, you and I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, you and I can put one foot in front of the other and know that he's guiding us all the way. You can overcome it. Because he overcame the world. The culmination of this weekend is that you can overcome. Because he said, I have overcome the world. That's what did I say? His spirit dwells and resides in you and me. He lives in us. And because he lives in us, you can and you will overcome the world. But the undefeated one is alive and well. And he's coming back again. He's coming back again. He's still saving souls. He's still reclaiming the backsliders. And one thing I know for sure this morning is that Jesus will not rub in your sins, but he'll rub them out. He will cast them into the sea of forgetfulness. And if you're here today listening and you need to be saved, or you need to come back to your first love, I must remind you, there's a coming day when another supper will take place. And it's called the marriage supper of the Lamb. Will you be there? Will you be there? Remember the prodigal son. When he came home, his father welcomed him home with open arms. I was also reminded that Peter denied Jesus three times. And Peter was so ashamed, even though Jesus told him that, yes, when the cock crows, you would have denied me three times. And when the cock did crow, and on the third one, Peter was reminded of those words. And during the 3 days, I can just imagine how Peter felt. But what happened when Jesus rose? He told Mary to go and get the disciples, and he specifically called Peter's name. And when Peter came, the love that he displayed to Peter showed his forgiveness. And when I think about the prodigal son, and when he came home and the father's love and his loving arms around him and the embrace, I think about the backslider that once loved and then departed and lost sight and lost hope of where they were in God. This morning, I'm telling you, it's like the love that Jesus displayed to Peter. It's like the prodigal son when his father welcomed him home and with open arms. That's what Jesus is saying to you this morning, the backslider. God is saying, come back. Come back. My arms are outstretched. My arms are outstretched and you are forgiven. Come back home. Come back home. What a day it will be on Resurrection Sunday for you to come back home. To know that the undefeated one overcame the world. And his spirit dwells and resides in you. And he's saying you too can overcome whatever trial, whatever issue, whatever circumstance you are in. I will lead you all the way. On this day, let's not forget what I have done, Jesus is saying, just for you. I did it all for you so that you can have an opportunity to sit at the marriage supper. Will you be among them? Will you be there? Today, Jesus is calling you home. This is not just a thing that we do every year, but what are you going to do different this year? He's saying, come home. Come home. Today I displayed that I paid the price just for you. I'm giving you another opportunity because access is granted unto you. The doors are open. Won't you come on in? The undefeated one overcame the world. And no matter what you're going through today, the Lord is saying, I have overcome the world, and so can you. Because I'm alive and I live forevermore. But best be assured, I'm coming back again. Will you be ready? Will you be ready? Will you take advantage today? Will you just put your hand in his hand? He's calling you home today. Let's let this go down in history. Let this go down where the redeemed and the angels, all of heaven, is rejoicing today. Because you say, I yield, I yield. What a day to say, God, because you have overcome the world, no matter what I'm going through, I'm going to put my hand in your hands and you will lead me all the way. Won't you come this morning? ReCharge Ministries is available to each and every one of you. If you want us to pray with you, I'm on Facebook, I'm on all of the social media platforms. Just send me a message and I'll call and pray with you. Because heaven is rejoicing today. Because the undefeated one has overcome the world. Won't you have the same experience and take a step? He's not asking you to figure it out, but take a step and put your hand in his hand. Let me just pray with you this morning. Abba, Father, I come before you. And I thank you for sending your son. And all things are placed under your feet today. Over 2,000 years ago, you went to the cross. You died. You were buried. But on the third day, you arose triumphantly, conquering death, hell, and the grave. You have ascended to the right hand of the Father. And you're making intercessions for me and the entire human race. Father, today we come before you. We thank you from a grateful heart, from a heart of thanksgiving. And we thank you for all that you have done and what you continue to do. Because it didn't just stop there. You're still moving. Even when we don't see you, you're moving. Even when we don't feel you, you're right there. Lord God, you're pulling us out of the pit. You're pulling us out of the dungeons and the valleys of despair. Lord God, you're walking with us. You're carrying us when we are weak. So, Lord God, we submit ourselves to you this morning. The wounded soldier, Lord God, they're coming home this morning. The battered and worn and the sad are coming home this morning. The ones that have been locked away in darkness are pushing toward the light this morning because you are the light. You are the light this morning. Some of us are on life support, but Lord, I thank you that you're the ultimate AED, Lord God, this morning. I thank you that you keep on infusing, Lord God, hallelujah, just to give us another chance. Many of us a fat line, but Lord God, you keep on applying. Oh God, because it ain't over till you say it's over, because you have the final say. And so, Lord God Almighty, this morning, as you are triumphant, as you are victorious, as you are the Lion of the tribe of Judah this morning, as you reign supreme, Lord God Almighty, I pray, Lord God, that you lift humanity, Lord God, this morning. Those that are crying out unto you, Lord God Almighty, they don't know where to turn, but Lord God, we're looking up, oh God, this morning, for whence cometh our help. Our help comes from you, Lord God, this morning. I pray, Almighty God, that the great clouds will fall off, Lord God, and they will hobble forward, Lord God. Just like when you say, Lazarus, come forward. This morning, your words, Lord God, has hit our heart. Lord God and your people are coming forward this morning. So, Lord God Almighty, as we come, Lord God, I thank you for the embrace. I thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah, for the assurance, knowing that we have a loving Father. This morning, we thank you, Lord God, for the love. We thank you, Lord God, that you're wiping us clean. Lord God, hallelujah. I thank you, Lord God, for the ones that are running this morning, for the ones that are saying, I don't know how, but Lord, I trust you. Lord God Almighty, this morning, you're going to make a way out of no way for that one this morning that decides, Lord God, to turn their back, oh God, on the enemy. Hallelujah, look forward to you, forward, ever, and backward, never. I thank you, Lord God, for what you are doing in this day and the fruits, hallelujah, that will come forward, Lord God, because your words will continue to reverberate across humanity. I give you thanks and praise, Lord God, in this moment for all those that have heard your word and will respond. Because when the word is given, there is a response that must be given as well. And I thank you, Lord God, for the responses to come back into the fold and to turn lives over into your hands as you lead us all the way. I give you thanks and I give you praise and I glorify and magnify your name in the name of the Father, the Son, and the blessed Holy Ghost. My name is Pastor Carleen Hepburn, one of the pastors here at ReCharge Ministries. Our God is awesome. What a day it is. Resurrection Sunday. He is risen. And the undefeated one says, I have overcome the world. And my spirit dwells inside of you. And because I have overcome the world, so can you. This morning, come, because his arms are outstretched. May the Lord bless and keep you this Resurrection Sunday. Let this be a day where you find newness and joy within our Lord and Savior. Facebook, may God bless and keep you always. May his face shine upon you. God bless you.